Nice work, big guy. Now for the next one. Almost there. Done and done. Thank you.
it.
Ignitus is waiting. Power.
architect must have been a beauty.
Still doesn't matter. Ignitus needs us.
I'm not complaining. I'm just saying it would be easier if she was smaller. A lot smaller.
Oh!
here we go! Spyro. Spyro.
What?
I don't like this. It feels like she's baiting us. I'm getting smarter.
Spyro! Destroy the crystal! Quickly!
Let's get him out of here before Cinder gets back.
If only it were that easy, little one.
So big.
Time you learned how complicated life can be.
Run! Spyro! Save yourself!
Not this time. This time I fight.
Bring it. In this way. Now, where was I?
Has she ever used doors?
There was something in her eyes, Ignitus. Something familiar.
There should be, Spyro. You and Cinder share more than you know. It's time I told you the truth. All of it. You see, after I took your egg to the Silver River, I returned to the grotto to find utter chaos. The other guardians had been overrun, and all the other eggs had been smashed by the Dark Master's forces. All except one. You see, the Dark Master was torn. He wanted to destroy all the eggs to prevent the birth of the Purple Dragon. But he also needed a dragon.
Why would he need a dragon?
Because, Spyro, only one born in the year of the dragon could open the portal that served as the Dark Master's prison.
Cinder?
I'm afraid so.
But if we come from the same place, why is she so...
Evil? Monstrous? Big? Sexy? Oops, did I say that?
Because, Spyro, after the night of the raid, she was corrupted by the Dark Master's poisonous powers, twisted by his evil lore. She's become the Dark Master's monster.
But why? What does this Dark Master want?
He wants to be freed from the portal of convexity, to wreak havoc across the realms. And if Cinder gets there, he just might succeed. I'm afraid we might be too late.
No, I refuse to give up. I'm going to stop Cinder and the Dark Master.
Wait, you heard the dragon, Spyro. He said, too late. We'll get him next time. Come on, champ. You did a great job, and let's take five.
No, I'm ready. Now!
Okay, Spyro, you're right. At the very least, you have to try. If the Dark Master escapes, a shadow will fall over the land. And who knows what will happen then. May the ancestors look after you. May they look after us all.
Convexity acts as an airlock between our world and the dark realms beyond. You must stop Cinder before she inserts the final crystal and activates the portal, freeing the Dark Master.
Now I've seen everything.
Yeah, if we don't hurry, I have a feeling you're gonna see a whole lot more. Come on.
Master returns.
We're too late.
Persistent little fellow, aren't you? This is where it really ends.
Bring it.
No mercy this time.
I can't watch this.
Thank you.
the true dragon within you.
Just like me.
Dude, we gotta get out of here now.
I can't leave her behind. I've got to save her.
What? Save the beast that's been trying to kill us?
Yeah, that wasn't her fault. She was being used by the Dark Master. We can go.
I'm right behind you, buddy.
Mommy, fluff my pillow.
Feeling better, Spyro?
Not really, Ignitus. That battle drained every last bit of my strength. I can hardly lift my head.
Yes, it will take some time for your powers to return. But they will in time, young dragon. They will in time. Cinder, ever since I failed the night of the raid, I've dreamt of this day.
It wasn't just you, Ignitus. We all failed.
Be that as it may, we're together again now. Thanks to Spyro. Well done, young dragon.
Thanks, Ignitus. But we still don't know what's happened to the Dark Master.
No matter, Spyro. There will be time to talk of the Dark Master later. Now it's time to be grateful for your success.
His success? Hey, what about me? Just because a bunch of weird stuff doesn't fly out of my mouth doesn't mean I didn't help you now.
Yeah, you were a big help, Sparks, no doubt about it. But just for the record, a lot of weird stuff does come out of that little mouth of yours.
And what the heck is that supposed to mean? You know, I don't need this. I could have stayed with the llama people, whatever, where I was appreciated, but no. No, I decided to help the poor, helpless dragons rid the world of evil. What a mistake that was, because I get no thanks. No respect, no love, no credit.
My goodness. And I thought Voltaire talked a lot.
I left home too, you know. I'm a little guy, yeah, that's right. Maybe you haven't noticed. Things are a lot bigger to me than they are to you. And did I back away? Uh-uh. Nah. Why? Because I got moxie. I'm a tough cookie. I got class. I got a little frog in my throat. As I was saying, on tall plains, they knew a good thing when they saw it. They recognized the value of a quality dragonfly like me. But here I get nothing. Not even a thanks. Hey, how you doing? Good. Let me buy you a drink. I should go back to the swamp. Mom will make it all good. Mommy always does.